Come, Holy Spirit, bless this and the word you preach that I may share with humility and with the heart, not just with the lips or the head. And may all people listen with their hearts, inspired by the Holy Spirit, not just with their ears. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Amen, Lord. Amen. Sisters and brothers, September. And with September, Christmas is near. For us Filipinos, with September, Christmas is here. Now na. Legit na raw. So anyway, wow, September. It's a beautiful time of the year when the heat of the summer slows down and we cooler weather. I like September, October, November. Oh, try to remember. You know that song? Try to remember that kind of September when life was young and oh so mellow, mellow. Try to remember, huh? And para naman sa mga makarelate, yung I'll see you in September. You remember that song? I'll see you in September when summer is gone. Ang kanta ng isa, I'll see you in September when summer is gone. Have the good time, but remember. Anyway, however you sing it, please learn. Go ahead, sing. Keep singing. And maybe that's what a disciple is. The one who sings for the Lord. The one who sings of the Lord. Today, the Lord teaches us about discipleship. Trying to remember, alam po nyo, did you know what I want to become when I was a little boy? Naku, wala pa yung priesthood noon. But as a little boy, I wanted to become a conductor. Bus conductor. Conductor ng bus. Well, ganito po yun. When you were growing up, you drive the pantranco buses then. One side is open and aisle lahat yan. And this conductor, I saw him while the bus is in motion. He would go from the front giving tickets, go back again, getting collection. While the bus is in motion, he was doing all this work. Wow, idol. And I wanted to have, you know, that courage of that bus conductor. Number two, the bus conductor was somebody who cared. Yun ang feeling ko eh, parang, you know, The bus stops, somebody comes in, he goes and gets the luggage, siya magkakarga, mga manok, mga kung ano-ano. Always, somebody goes down, he would be the one to... This guy cared, he served. And third, the bus conductor was the storyteller in the bus. You know, the bus was like 20 people, 30 people. And he would talk. He would tell stories. Oh, this guy was animating everyone during the journey. I said, I want to be someone like that. Yun. Well, I did not become a bus conductor. I became a priest. I became a conductor of the boss. Something like that. And I look at my priesthood simply that. You know, someone who, a conductor, one who conducts people to God and God to the people. Pero maganda po yung word na conductor, conducere, Latin, to lead with. Even that somebody was just leading and pointing, you are with the people. That's leadership. That's the conductor. All throughout the journey, we need conductors. People who lead God to His people and the people to His God. We all are conductors. And my work is basically that, serving people, helping people carry their baggage and loading. Shouldn't we all be doing that? And finally, a storyteller. Keep telling stories of God's love, of beautiful values. Ano ba mga story mo? Palaging kinakalat mo ang story, ano nangyari kay sa Facebook, kung ano. Huh? Talk God. That's the call of the disciple. So my dear friends, today, please remember, we have a role. Ang hirap po maging disciple because there is a cost for discipleship. Number one, the Lord mentions today in the gospel, it's about leaving behind father and mother, relationship, possessions to follow the Lord. And number two, carry your cross daily and follow the Lord. By the way, there's no such thing as a perfect disciple. No. There was only one perfect disciple. Mama Mary. She was the first disciple who loved Jesus most. Don't anyone say, I love Jesus more than Mary. She should not be a part of the picture. Hello. You don't know what you're talking about. This was the one who loved him most. We honor Mary. Happy birthday, Mama Mary. Paalaala lang po, ha? Malapit na. And, well, okay. Today I ask you, what have you sacrificed for the Lord? What have you given up for your God? It's an important question. What have you offered to God? Oh, Father, every Sunday I offer my offering. Ako ng katiting, katiting. That's it. That's disciple. God asks more than what your money. God asks each one of us your time, your talent, and your love. Now, seriously speaking, is payback time happening now in your life? God has been so good to you and to me. What are you doing the rest of your life? We will report to God someday. What will we tell the Lord? Sisters and brothers, paala-ala lang po. There must be something or someone bigger than yourself that you live for. Don't live just for yourself. That's what discipleship is all about. And it's an ongoing journey to God's heart. We are all a work in progress. Wala pong perfect disciple, but we keep trying to offer. A disciple is someone who offers. We offer. What is offer? O-F-F-E-R-S. Okay, check please. The first one is obedience. Giving up my will to follow God's will. Giving up my desires, my inclinations, because I want to follow what God is telling. And I want to remember that others also need my mindfulness, not just my will, my way. Discipleship saying, Lord, your way. And obeying. Ang hirap po mag-obey as you grow older. For us in the society, religious, oh, by the way, birthday of the SVD also on September 8th. Well, many of your students become your superiors as you grow older. That's obedience. Thy will be done. So what is our constant prayer? Thy will be done, Lord. All of us, that's an ongoing struggle. Just keep saying, Lord, thy will, not my will, but thy will be done. Number two, discipleship is about faithfulness, pagiging tapat at tunay. Number one po ay faithfulness to God. Ang ganda po ng sinabi ni Mother Teresa, you are called to be a disciple, not so much to be successful or popular, but to be faithful. Speaking of faithfulness, this morning I got the news that there's a 91-year-old Lola who wanted to join the Mass, Nanay Cristina de Guzman, because she wanted to attend a Mass. That's faithfulness. Oh, by the way, the online Masses are supplementary now. Those who can go to church, go to church. This is now because the churches are now open. Okay? Faithfulness in little things, mga kapatid. And the other thing is, even with your cross, remain faithful. Kasi mga iba, pag dumating ng cross, wala na si Lord. No, especially when you go through difficulties and trials, that's when your faithfulness really shines. Faithfulness. Stay with the Lord. And the song we are singing is, Lord, into your hands I commend my spirit. Be faithful to the Lord. Be true. And number three, a disciple is free. Try to be free from, to be free for. Freedom from attachments, from your own personal agenda, freedom from your internal prisons, ang dami kang preso, and from external prisons, hindi ka na makagawa ng para kay Lord kasi yun, marami kang preso sa buhay mo. Be free. Sisters and brothers, one more thing po, by the way, you have a cross. How did you carry? How do you carry your cross? Baka tanuin ka ni Lord later on, oh, paano mo binuhat ang cross mo? We all have cross. All of us will have a cross. Paano mo binuhat? Ah, dyan nagkakaiba. You carry the cross with the Lord. And please, don't pass your cross. Yan ang pass the load. Yung mga pagkahi mo, galit ka, so you say, oh, galit ako sa inyong lahat. Huh? Don't pass the load. Pass the Lord. I can hear parents treating the children like this, because of a hang-up they had. Don't pass on your garbage, please. Let the garbage stop with you. Don't pass on your quarrels to your children, your bad habits. No. Be kind. Freedom from selfishness, freedom from attachments. And what's important is if you are free, put God first and above the rest. Above your family, above your attachments, your affiliations, whatever. And a song we should be singing always is, All for You, My Lord, All for You. Para po sa inyong ladito, I am free. Number four, disciple is all about being an expression of God's love. Nay, sa pamamagitan mo sana na i-express yung pagmamahal ng Diyos. You become an instrument of God's peace, a loving presence. Sa pamamagitan mo na i-express ang Panginoon. Ang problema sa mga ibang disciple, mas focus sila sa pagiging impressive. Nakakalimutan pagiging expressive. To say thank you to people, to say, hey, you're okay. All will be well. Be a someone, not so much a somebody. You know, mga kapatid, focus on expressing God's love. Not so much impressing others. Then you become a true disciple. Number five, offer discipleship is about a relationship with your God. Prayer. Kung wala pong prayer life, a disciple is empty. A clanging cymbal. Maingay lang. Kung wala pong pagmamahal, a disciple is just a functionary. May office ka, ganon. Somebody who does this and that. Or a missionary is just a mercenary. Bayaran. The heart, that's what the relationship is all about. And please be someone to people. Not just a somebody. Wow, ang galing, tinitingala, popular, ang daming trabaho niya. But are you a someone to your helpers? Are you a someone to a little child? This is what it means. Puso pa rin po mga kapatid. Saranghe. Ma'am, onje na ma'am. Cheil. Cheil, number one, is the heart. That's for discipleship. And you, a disciple is someone who cares. Sana maramdaman po na mga tao yan. Someone who cares. Someone who cares. Someone who dares to love you. Pag kumakanta ko, walang nakaka-relate, kaya sige lang. Yes, and we keep saying, Lord, without you, I am nothing. Claro. Without the Lord, who are we? What are we? It's the Lord. Today, you say now, as for me and for my house, we will serve the Lord. From the book of Joshua. And that's the last thing. S, service. Discipleship is about service, not self-service. And yes, today, families who are joining us now, please agree and tell one another, yes, as for me, for our house, we will serve the Lord. We are disciples. And what we are singing is, did I fill the world with love? Anong kinalat mo habang buhay ka pa? Nagkalat ka ba ng kadiliman? Nagkalat ka lang ng kasamaan? Bottom line is, did I fill the world with love? Did I serve people? Brothers and sisters, again, we honor Mama Mary, the first disciple, the one who loved Jesus most. Many disciples come lately, tell them, wala yun si Mama Mary. You don't know how much this woman shared everything from the very start. That's why we honor her. She will be the first one to tell us, don't adore me. No, no, no. Only my son. Claro po yan sa ating Panginoon. And thank you again. Happy birthday to the Society of the Divine Word. We were founded in 1875. St. Arnold Johnson, Germany, and the first missionary. The society was supposed, the foremost mission was mission to China. And the first missionary there was St. Joseph Fernandez. So dear friends, I'm so happy also that here in the mission house, this is the home of 125 Filipino SVD missionaries working all over the world to tell the world of Islam. By the way, just a one, the blessing of our sanctuary of the Divine Word, our prayer park, will be on October 1 already. And the walk with God to Manawag will be on October 8th. All to honor our Mother Mary. So dear friends, we bow our heads. Lord, we are not perfect disciples. We still have so much to learn about true love, true humility. Help us to continue to obey, to be faithful, to be free from attachments, to be free for the kingdom. May we become expressions, living witnesses of your loving presence in this world. May we be someone, a someone who cares. May we never forget to be a someone to you, because without you, we are empty, we are vain, we are proud and shallow. And help us to keep serving, to be conductors. People who serve and who continue to tell the most beautiful story ever told. To be a storyteller of God's love in this world. Mama Mary, teach us. You are our mother and our model. Teach us to be true disciples of your Son. Amen, Lord. Amen. Number two, have, you know, that courage of that bus conductor. Number two, the bus conductor was somebody who cared. You know, feeling ko eh, parang, you know, the bus stops, somebody comes in, he goes and gets the luggage, siya magkakarga, mga manok, mga kung ano-ano. Always, somebody goes down, he would be the one to, this guy cared, he served. And third, the bus conductor was the storyteller in the bus. You know, the bus was like 20 people, 30 people. And he would talk, he would tell stories. Oh, this guy was animating everyone during the journey. I said, I want to be someone like that. Yun. Well, I did not become a bus conductor. I became a priest. I became a conductor of the bus. Something like that. And I look at my priesthood simply that. You know, someone who, a conductor, one who conducts people to God and God to the people. Pero maganda po yung word na conductor. Conducere, Latin. To lead with. Even that somebody was just leading and pointing, you are with the people. That's leadership. That's the conductor. All throughout the journey, we need conductors. People who lead God to His people and the people to His God. We all are conductors. And my work is basically that. Serving people, helping people carry their baggage and loading. Shouldn't we all be doing that? And finally, a storyteller. Keep telling stories of God's love, of beautiful values. Ano ba mga story mo? Palaging kinakalat mo ang story, ano nangyari kay sa Facebook, kung ano. Huh? Talk God. That's the call of the disciple. So my dear friends, today, please remember, we have a role. Ang hirap po maging disciple because there is a cost for discipleship. Number one, the Lord mentions today in the gospel, it's about leaving behind father and mother, relationship, possessions to follow the Lord. And number two, carry your cross daily and follow the Lord. By the way, there's no such thing as a perfect disciple. No. There was only one perfect disciple. Mama Mary. She was the first disciple who loved Jesus most. Don't anyone say, I love Jesus more than Mary. She should not be a part of the picture. Hello. You don't know what you're talking about. This was the one who loved Him most. We honor Mary. Happy birthday, Mama Mary. Paalaala lang po ha. Malapit na. And, well, okay. Today I ask you, what have you sacrificed for the Lord? What have you given up for your God? It's an important question. What have you offered
to God. Oh, Father, every Sunday I offer my offering ako ng katiting. That's it. That's disciple. God asks more than what your money. God asks each one of us your time, your talent, and your love. Now, seriously speaking, is payback time happening now in your life? God has been so good to you and to me. What are you doing the rest of your life? We will report to God someday. What will we tell the Lord? Sisters and brothers, paalaala lang po. There must be something or someone bigger than yourself that you live for. Don't live just for yourself. That's what discipleship is all about. And it's an ongoing journey to God's heart. We are all a work in progress. Wala pong perfect disciple, but we keep trying to offer. A disciple is someone who offers. We offer. What is offer? O-F-F-E-R-S. Okay, check please. The first one is obedience. Giving up my will to follow God's will. Giving up my desires, my inclinations, because I want to follow what God is telling. And I want to remember that others also need my mindfulness, not just my will, my way. Discipleship is saying, Lord, your way. And obeying. Ang hirap po mag-obey as you grow older. For us in the society, religious, oh, by the way, birthday of the SVD also on September 8th. Well, many of your students become your superiors as you grow older. That's obedience. Thy will be done. So what is our constant prayer? Thy will be done, Lord. All of us, that's an ongoing struggle. Just keep saying, Lord, thy will. Not my will, but thy will be done. Number two, discipleship is about faithfulness. Pagiging tapat at tunay. Number one po ay faithfulness to God. Ang ganda po ng sinabi ni Mother Teresa, you are called to be a disciple, not so much to be successful or popular, but to be faithful. Speaking of faithfulness, this morning I got the news that there's a 91-year-old Lola who wanted to join the Mass. Nanay Cristina de Guzman, because she wanted to attend a Mass. That's faithfulness. Oh, by the way, the online Masses are supplementary now. Those who can go to church, go to church. This is now, because the churches are now open. Okay? Faithfulness in little things, mga kapatid. And the other thing is, even with your cross, remain faithful. Kasi mga iba, pag dumating ng cross, wala na si Lord. No, especially when you go through difficulties and trials, that's when your faithfulness really shines. Faithfulness. Stay with the Lord. And the song we are singing is, Lord, into your hands I commend my spirit. Be faithful to the Lord. Be true. And number three, a disciple is free. Try to be free from. To be free for. Freedom from attachments, from your own personal agenda, freedom from your internal prisons, ang dami kang preso, and from external prisons, hindi ka na makagawa ng para kay Lord kasi yun, marami kang preso sa buhay mo. Be free. Sisters and brothers, one more thing po, by the way, you have a cross. How did you carry? How do you carry your cross? Baka tanungin ka ni Lord later on, oh, paano mo binuhat ang cross mo? We all have cross. All of us, we have a cross. Paano binuhat? Ah, dyan nagkakaiba. You carry the cross with the Lord. And please, don't pass your cross. Yan ang pass the load. Yung mga bagahe mo, galit ka, so you say, oh, galit ako sa inyong lahat. Huh? Don't pass the load. Pass the Lord. I can hear parents treating the children like this, because of a hang-up they had. Don't pass on your garbage, please. Let the garbage stop with you. Don't pass on your quarrels to your children, your bad habits. No. Be kind. Freedom from selfishness, freedom from attachments. And what's important is if you are free, put God first and above the rest. Above your family, above your attachments, your affiliations, whatever. And a song we should be singing always is, All for you, my Lord. All for you. Para po sa inyong lahat ito, I am free. Number four, disciple is all about being an expression of God's love. Na sa pamamagitan mo sana, na i-express yung pagmamahal ng Diyos. You become an instrument of God's peace, a loving presence. Sa pamamagitan mo, na i-express ang Panginoon. Ang problema sa mga ibang disciple, mas focus sila sa pagiging impressive. Nakakalimutan pagiging expressive. To say thank you to people, to say, hey, you're okay, all will be well. Be a someone, not so much a somebody. You know, mga kapatid, focus on expressing God's love, not so much impressing others. Then you become a true disciple. Number five, offer discipleship is about a relationship with your God. Prayer. Kung wala pong prayer life, a disciple is empty. A clanging symbol. Maingay lang. Kung wala pong pagmamahal, a disciple is just a functionary. May office ka, ganon. Somebody who does this and that. Or a missionary is just a mercenary. Bayaran. The heart, that's what the relationship is all about. And please be someone to people. Not just a somebody. Wow, ang galing, tinitingala, popular, ang daming trabaho niya. But are you a someone to your helpers? Are you a someone to a little child? This is what it means. Puso pa rin po mga kapatid. Saranghe. Ma'am. Onje na ma'am. Jail. Jail. Number one is the heart. That's for discipleship. And you, a disciple is someone who cares. Sana maramdaman po ng mga tao yan. Someone who cares. Someone who cares. Someone who dares to love you. Pag kumakanta po, walang nakaka-relate, kaya sige lang. Yes, and we keep saying, Lord, without you, I am nothing. Claro. Without the Lord, who are we? What are we? It's the Lord. Today, you say now, as for me and for my house, we will serve the Lord. From the book of Joshua. And that's the last thing. S, service. Discipleship is about service, not self-service. And yes, today, families who are joining us now, please agree and tell one another, yes, as for me, for our house, we will serve the Lord. We are disciples. And what we are singing is, did I fill the world with love? Anong kinalat mo habang buhay ka pa? Nagkalat ka ba ng kadiliman? Nagkalat ka lang ng kasamaan? Bottom line is, did I fill the world with love? Did I serve people? Brothers and sisters, again, we honor Mama Mary, the first disciple, the one who loved Jesus most. Many disciple come lately, tell them, ah, wala yun si Mama Mary. You don't know how much this woman shared everything from the very start. That's why we honor her. She will be the first one to tell us, don't adore me. No, no, no. Only my son. Claro po yan sa ating Panginoon. And thank you again. Happy birthday to the Society of the Divine Word. We were founded in 1875, St. Arnold Janssen, Germany. And the first missionary. The society was supposed, the foremost mission was mission to China. And the first missionary there was St. Joseph Fernandez. So dear friends, I'm so happy also that here in the Mission House, this is the home of 125 Filipino SVD missionaries working all over the world to tell the world of His love. By the way, just a quan, the blessing of our Sanctuary of the Divine Word, our prayer park, will be on October 1 already. And the Walk with God to Manawag will be on October 8th, all to honor our Mother Mary. So dear friends, we bow our heads. Lord, we are not perfect disciples. We still have so much to learn. about true love, true humility. Help us to continue to obey, to be faithful, to be free from attachments, to be free for the kingdom. May we become expressions, living witnesses of your loving presence in this world. May we be someone, a someone who cares. May we never forget to be a someone to you, because without you, we are empty, we are vain, we are proud and shallow. And help us to keep serving, to be conductors, people who serve and who continue to tell the most beautiful story ever told, to be a storyteller of God's love in this world. Mama Mary, teach us. You are our mother and our model. Teach us to be true disciples of your Son. Amen, Lord. Amen.
Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On one occasion, when a great crowd was with Jesus, he turned to them and said, "If anyone comes to me without turning his back on his father and mother, his wife and his children, his brothers and sisters, indeed his very self, he cannot be my follower. Anyone who does not take up his cross and follow me cannot be my disciple. If any one of you decides to build a tower, will he not first sit down and calculate the outlay to see if he has enough money to complete the project? He will do that for fear of laying the foundation and then not being able to complete the work, at which all who saw it would then jeer at him, saying, 'That man began to build what he could not finish.' Or if a king is about to march on another king to do battle with him, will he not sit down first and consider whether with 10,000 men he can withstand an enemy coming against him with 20,000? If he cannot, he will send a delegation while the enemy is still at a distance, asking for terms of peace. In the same way, none of you can be my disciple if he does not renounce all his possessions." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
faithfulness to God. Ang ganda po ng sinabi ni Mother Teresa, you are called to be a disciple, not so much to be successful or popular, but to be faithful. Speaking of faithfulness, this morning I got the news that there's a 91-year-old Lola who wanted to join the Mass, Nanay Cristina de Guzman, because she wanted to attend a Mass. That's faithfulness. Oh, by the way, the online Masses are supplementary now. Those who can go to church, go to church. This is now because the churches are now open. Okay? Faithfulness in little things, mga kapatid. And the other thing is, even with your cross, remain faithful. Kasi mga iba, pag dumating ng cross, wala na si Lord. No, especially when you go through difficulties and trials, that's when your faithfulness really shines. Faithfulness. Stay with the Lord. And the song we are singing is, Lord, into your hands I commend my spirit. Be faithful to the Lord. Be true. And number three, a disciple is free. Try to be free from, to be free for. Freedom from attachments, from your own personal agenda, freedom from your internal prisons, ang dami kang preso, and from external prisons, hindi ka na makagawa ng para kay Lord kasi yun, marami kang preso sa buhay mo. Be free. Sisters and brothers, one more thing po, by the way, you have a cross. How did you carry? How do you carry your cross? Baka tanuin ka ni Lord later on, oh, paano mo binuhat ang cross mo? We all have cross. All of us will have a cross. Paano binuhat? Ah, dyan nakakaiba. You carry the cross with the Lord. And please, don't pass your cross. Yan ang pass the load. Yung mga bagahe mo, galit ka, so you say, oh, galit ako sa inyong lahat. Huh? Don't pass the load. Pass the Lord. I can hear parents treating the children like this, because of a hang-up they had. Don't pass on your garbage, please. Let the garbage stop with you. Don't pass on your quarrels to your children, your bad habits. No. Be kind. Freedom from selfishness, freedom from attachments. And what's important is if you are free, put God first and above the rest. Above your family, above your attachments, your affiliations, whatever. And a song we should be singing always is, All for You, My Lord. All for you. Para po sa inyong lahat ito, I am free. Number four, disciple is all about being an expression of God's love. Nay, sa pamamagitan mo sana, nai-express yung pagmamahal ng Diyos. You become an instrument of God's peace, a loving presence. Sa pamamagitan mo na i-express ang Panginoon. Ang problema sa mga ibang disciple, mas focus sila sa pagiging impressive. Nakakalimutan pagiging expressive. To say thank you to people, to say, hey, you're okay, all will be well. Be a someone, not so much a somebody. You know, mga kapatid, focus on expressing God's love, not so much impressing others. Then you become a true disciple. Number five, offer discipleship is about a relationship with your God. Prayer. Kung wala pong prayer life, a disciple is empty, a clanging cymbal. Maingay lang. Kung wala pong pagmamahal, a disciple is just a functionary. May office ka, ganon. Somebody who does this and that. Or a missionary is just a mercenary. Bayaran. The heart. That's what the relationship is all about. And please be someone to people, not just a somebody. Wow, ang galing, tinitingala, popular, ang daming trabaho niya. But are you a someone to your helpers? Are you a someone to a little child? This is what it means. Puso pa rin po, mga kapatid. Saranghe. Ma'am, onje na ma'am. Cheil. Cheil, number one, is the heart. That's for discipleship. And you, a disciple is someone who cares. Sana maramdaman po na mga tao yan. Someone who cares. Someone who cares. Someone who dares to love you. Pag kumakanta ko, walang nakaka-relate, kaya sige lang. Yes, and we keep saying, Lord, without you, I am nothing. Claro. Without the Lord, who are we? What are we? It's the Lord. Today, you say now, as for me and for my house, we will serve the Lord. From the book of Joshua. And that's the last thing. S, service. Discipleship is about service, not self-service. And yes, today, families who are joining us now, please agree and tell one another, yes, as for me, for our house, we will serve the Lord. We are disciples. And what we are singing is, did I fill the world with love? Anong kinalat mo habang buhay ka pa? Nagkalat ka ba ng kadiliman? Nagkalat ka lang ng kasamaan? Bottom line is, did I fill the world with love? Did I serve people? Brothers and sisters, again, we honor Mama Mary, the first disciple, the one who loved Jesus most. Many disciples come lately, tell them, wala yun si Mama Mary. You don't know how much this woman shared everything from the very start. That's why we honor her. She will be the first one to tell us, don't adore me. No, no, no. Only my son. Claro po yan sa ating Panginoon. And thank you again. Happy birthday to the Society of the Divine Word. We were founded in 1875, St. Arnold Janssen, Germany. And the first missionary, the Society was supposed, the foremost mission was mission to China. And the first missionary there was St. Joseph Fernandez. So dear friends, I'm so happy also that here in the Mission House, this is the home of 125 Filipino SVD missionaries working all over the world to tell the world of Islam. By the way, Joseph, the blessing of our Sanctuary of the Divine Word, our prayer park, will be on October 1 already. And the Walk with God to Manawag will be on October 8. All to honor our Mother Mary. So dear friends, we bow our heads. Lord, we are not perfect disciples. We still have so much to learn about true love, true humility. Help us to continue to obey, to be faithful, to be free from attachments, to be free for the kingdom. May we become expressions, living witnesses of your loving presence in this world. May we be someone who cares. May we never forget to be a someone to you, because without you, we are empty, we are vain, we are proud and shallow. And help us to keep serving, to be conductors. People who serve and who continue to tell the most beautiful story ever told. To be a storyteller of God's love in this world. Mama Mary, teach us. You are our mother and our model. Teach us to be true disciples of your Son. Amen, Lord. Amen. Number two, you know that courage of that bus conductor. Number two, the bus conductor was somebody who cared. You know, feeling ko eh, parang, you know, the bus stops, somebody comes in, he goes and gets the luggage, siya magkakarga, mga manok, mga kung ano-ano. Always, somebody goes down, he would be the one to, this guy cared, he served. And third, the bus conductor was the storyteller in the bus. You know, the bus was like 20 people, 30 people. And he would talk, he would tell stories. Oh, this guy was animating everyone during the journey. I said, I want to be someone like that. Yun. Well, I did not become a bus conductor. I became a priest. I became a conductor of the bus. Something like that. And I look at my priesthood simply that. A conductor, one who conducts people to God and God to the people. Pero maganda po yung word na conductor. Conducere, Latin. To lead with. Even that somebody was just leading and pointing, you are with the people. That's leadership. That's the conductor. All throughout the journey, we need conductors. People who lead God to His people and the people to His God. We all are conductors. And my work is basically that. Serving people, helping people carry their baggage and loading. Shouldn't we all be doing that? And finally, a storyteller. Keep telling stories of God's love, of beautiful values. Ano ba mga story mo? Palaging kinakalat mo ang story, ano nangyari kay sa Facebook, kung ano. Huh? Talk God. That's the call of the disciple. So my dear friends, today, please remember, we have a role. Ang hirap po maging disciple because there is a cost for discipleship. Number one, the Lord mentions today in the gospel, it's about leaving behind father and mother, relationship, possessions to follow the Lord. And number two, carry your cross daily and follow the Lord. By the way, there's no such thing as a perfect disciple. No. There was only one perfect disciple, Mama Mary. She was the first disciple who loved Jesus most. Don't anyone say, I love Jesus more than Mary. She should not be a part of the picture. Hello. You don't know what you're talking about. This was the one who loved him most. We honor Mary. Happy birthday, Mama Mary. Paalaala lang po ha. Malapit na. And, well, okay. Today I ask you, what have you sacrificed for the Lord? What have you given up for your God? It's an important question. What have you offered to God? Oh, Father, every Sunday I offer. May offering ako ng katiting, katiting. That's it. That's disciple. God asks more than what your money. God asks each one of us your time, your talent, and your love. Now, seriously speaking, is payback time happening now in your life? God has been so good to you and to me. What are you doing the rest of your life? We will report to God someday. What will we tell the Lord? Sisters and brothers, paalaala lang po. There must be something or someone bigger than yourself that you live for. Don't live just for yourself. That's what discipleship is all about. And it's an ongoing journey to God's heart. We are all a work in progress. Wala pong perfect disciple, but we keep trying to offer. A disciple is someone who offers. We offer. What is offer? O-F-F-E-R. Yes. Okay, check please. The first one is obedience. Giving up my will to follow God's will. Giving up my desires, my inclinations, because I want to follow what God is telling. And I want to remember that others also need my mindfulness. Not just my will, my way. Disciples have been saying, Lord, your way. And obeying. Ang hirap po mag-obey as you grow older. For us in the society, religious, oh, by the way, birthday of the SVD also on September 8th. Well, many of your students become your superiors as you grow older. That's obedience. Thy will be done. So what is our constant prayer? Thy will be done, Lord. All of us, that's an ongoing struggle. Just keep saying, Lord, thy will, not my will, but thy will be done. Number two, discipleship is about faithfulness, pagiging tapat at tunay. Number one po ay faithfulness to God. Ang ganda po ng sinabi ni Mother Teresa, you are called to be a disciple, not so much to be successful or popular, but to be faithful. Speaking of faithfulness, this morning I got the news that there's a 91-year-old Lola who wanted to join the Mass. Nanay Cristina de Guzman, because she wanted to attend a Mass. That's faithfulness. Oh, by the way, the online Masses are supplementary now. Those who can go to church, go to church. This is now, because the churches are now open. Okay? Faithfulness in little things, mga kapatid. And the other thing is, even with your cross, remain faithful. Kasi mga iba, pag dumating ng cross, wala na si Lord. No, especially when you go through difficulties and trials, that's when your faithfulness really shines. Faithfulness. stay with the Lord. And the song we are singing is, Lord, into your hands I commend my spirit. Be faithful to the Lord. Be true. And number three, a disciple is free. Try to be free from, to be free for. Freedom from attachments, from your own personal agenda, freedom from your internal prisons, ang dami kang preso, and from external prisons, hindi ka na makagawa ng para kay Lord kasi yun, marami kang preso sa buhay mo. Be free. Sisters and brothers, one more thing po, by the way, you have a cross. How did you carry? How do you carry your cross? Baka tanungin ka ni Lord later on, oh, paano mo binuhat ang cross mo? We all have cross. All of us, we have a cross. Paano binuhat? Ah, dyan nagkakaiba. You carry the cross with the Lord. And please, don't pass your cross. Yan ang pass the load. Yung mga bagahe mo, galit ka, so you say, oh, galit ako sa inyong lahat. Ha? Huh? Don't pass the load. Pass the Lord. I can hear parents treating the children like this, because of a hang-up they had. Don't pass on your garbage, please. Let the garbage stop with you. Don't pass on your quarrels to your children, your bad habits. No. Be kind. Freedom from selfishness, freedom from attachments. And what's important is if you are free, put God first and above the rest. Above your family, above your attachments, your affiliations, whatever. And a song we should be singing always is, All for you, my Lord. All for you. Para po sa inyong lahat ito, I am free. Number four, disciple is all about being an expression of God's love. Sa pamamagitan mo sana, nai-express yung pagmamahal ng Diyos. You become an instrument of God's peace, a loving presence. Sa pamamagitan mo, nai-express ang Panginoon. Ang problema sa mga ibang disciple, mas focus sila sa pagiging impressive. Nakakalimutan pagiging expressive. To say thank you to people, to say, hey, you're okay, all will be well. Be a someone, not so much a somebody. You know, mga kapatid, focus on expressing God's love, not so much impressing others. Then you become a true disciple. Number five, offer discipleship is about a relationship with your God. Prayer. Kung wala pong prayer life, a disciple is empty. A clanging cymbal. Maingay lang. Kung wala pong pagmamahal, a disciple is just a functionary. May office ka, ganon. Somebody who does this and that. Or a missionary is just a mercenary. Bayaran. The heart. That's what the relationship is all about. And please be someone to people. Not just a somebody. Wow, ang galing, tinitingala, popular, ang daming trabaho niya. But are you a someone to your helpers? Are you a someone to a little child? This is what it means. Puso pa rin po mga kapatid. Saranghe. Ma'am, onje na ma'am. Chael, number one is the heart. That's for discipleship. And a disciple is someone who cares. Sana maramdaman po ng mga tao yan. Someone who cares. Someone who cares. Someone who dares to love you. Pag kumakanta po, walang nakaka-relate. Kaya sige lang. Yes, and we keep saying, Lord, without you, I am nothing. Claro. Without the Lord, who are we? What are we? It's the Lord. Today, you say now, as for me and for my house, we will serve the Lord. From the book of Joshua. And that's the last thing. S, service. Discipleship is about service, not self-service. And yes, today, families who are joining us now, please agree and tell one another, yes, as for me, for our house, we will serve the Lord. We are disciples. And what we are singing is, did I fill the world with love? Anong kinalat mo habang buhay ka pa? Nagkalat ka ba ng kadiliman? Nagkalat ka lang ng kasamaan? Bottom line is, did I fill the world with love? Did I serve people? Brothers and sisters, again, we honor Mama Mary, the first disciple, the one who loved Jesus most. Many disciples come lately, tell them, ah, wala yun si Mama Mary. You don't know how much this woman shared everything from the very start. That's why we honor her. She will be the first one to tell us, don't adore me. No, 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 only my son. Klaro po yan sa ating Panginoon. And thank you again. Happy birthday to the Society of the Divine Word. We were founded in 1875, St. Arnold Janssen, Germany. And the first missionary, the society was supposed, the foremost mission was mission to China. And the first missionary there was St. Joseph Fernandez. So dear friends, I'm so happy also that here in the Mission House, this is the home of 125 Filipino SVD missionaries working all over the world to tell the world of His love. By the way, the blessing of our Sanctuary of the Divine Word, our prayer park, will be on October 1 already. And the Walk with God to Manawag will be on October 8, all to honor our Mother Mary. So dear friends, we bow our heads. Lord, we are not perfect disciples. We still have so much to learn about true love, true humility. Help us to continue to obey, to be faithful, to be free from attachments, to be free for the kingdom. May we become expressions, living witnesses of your loving presence in this world. May we be someone, a someone who cares. May we never forget to be a someone to you. Because without you, we are empty, we are vain, we are proud and shallow. And help us to keep serving, to be conductors. People who serve and who continue to tell the most beautiful story ever told. To be a storyteller of God's love in this world. Mama Mary, teach us. You are our mother and our model. Teach us to be true disciples of your Son. Amen, Lord. Amen.
Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On one occasion, when a great crowd was with Jesus, he turned to them and said, "If anyone comes to me without turning his back on his father and mother, his wife and his children, his brothers and sisters, indeed his very self, he cannot be my follower. Anyone who does not take up his cross and follow me cannot be my disciple. If any one of you decides to build a tower, will he not first sit down and calculate the outlay to see if he has enough money to complete the project? He will do that for fear of laying the foundation and then not being able to complete the work, at which all who saw it would then jeer at him, saying, 'That man began to build what he could not finish.' Or if a king is about to march on another king to do battle with him, will he not sit down first and consider whether with 10,000 men he can withstand an enemy coming against him with 20,000? If he cannot, he will send a delegation while the enemy is still at a distance, asking for terms of peace. In the same way, none of you can be my disciple if he does not renounce all his possessions. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.